Knocking down McNair. Going right side here, and that's complete. And they'll get nine there as that sets them up better for third down. And now they're in the hurry up. Out of the gun, it's McNair. Going to throw right side here, complete. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Now McNair looking for a first down throw. And this is Shepard on the catch. And he's brought down. It's a pickup of 19. And that enables him to also pick up the first. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And it's incomplete. Boy, he doesn't drop many like that one. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Now McNair. This will be caught at the two. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. And a nice pitch and catch to pick up the reception against man coverage.
Both of them read how much yardage they needed, figured what they had to do, and were able to beat the man coverage.
And he will have a touchdown. Steve McNair punching it in from a yard away. And his guys have made this a one-score game now.
Okay, I know it's an old line, but it still applies here. The fat lady has not sung yet. She may be warming up, but she hasn't sung yet. There's still an opportunity.
A drive that time of six plays. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. A beautiful fake. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30 to the 33-yard line. The Jets offense now works their way back onto the field. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage. Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer. Create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive.
Hey, ready.
On first down, this is Forte. And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. Now here's a timeout coming on the defensive side of the ball. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. They stay on the ground, Forte again. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. And now whistles blow here. Play is stopped, and we're going to get a timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Fitzpatrick now going to give to Forte. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
One of the things I love about this game is there's a match of wits throughout the game. Who's going to get the advantage? Who's going to catch someone off guard? I feel like the offense thought they might catch the defense off balance with that play call, but unfortunately, that didn't work for them.
Now this is fielded in the end zone. Great blocking, nearly sprung in there. 28-yard return, and the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because
there goes Sterling Shepard, the 20. A big play there on the catch and run. And even 80 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the...
He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. Wow. So how many practices have we watched over time where the offense works on scoring late in the game and finding a way to win, as we just saw there?
Just saw it right there. Now can they preserve that advantage that they just got? The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be taken about the 12. He juked him. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The New York set to take the field. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now, you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence.
Oh, he caught it. Just... This challenge was initiated by the guys in New York taking a look at the play. Less than 2 minutes to go.
Yeah, I'm sure the coach wanted to challenge it, so he's probably going to send the New York office a holiday card. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And he'll get this one out to the 50 to the midfield stripe. But what a turnaround. They exited the lockers with a nice lead, and now all of this. What's happened?
So when you start to write your novel, you'll start out with, it was a tale of two halves, weren't you?
But not a bad way.
I don't know exactly what happened because sometimes teams can go in with a lead and get too caught.
Now here's a timeout defensively. Defensive timeout called by the Jets. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add three more little insult to injury here late in the game. From the right hash, this from 44 yards out. And the kick is good. So you wonder how this one might be remembered the next time these two teams meet. But until then, this game's over. A great come-from-behind victory in this one, Charles.
Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos, follow me on social media, and once again, thanks for watching.